All right, guys, are you ready for another challenge? In this challenge, you're going to be building a pizza order program. So we're going to ask the user what size pizza they want, small, medium, or large, whether if they want to add pepperoni to it, and whether if they want extra cheese. So based on the user's input for each of these variables, and the input's going to come in the form of a single capital letter, S, M, or L, Y, or N. Based on that input, we're going to try and figure out what their final bill is going to come to. And you can take a look at the prices over here. So if you want to add pepperoni for a small pizza, it's $2. Medium or large pizza is $3. And extra cheese is $1 for any size. So you're going to use what you've learned about multiple if statements, as well as everything from previously, in order to be able to create this. So that if the user types in, for example, this inputs, large pepperoni with no extra cheese, then it should print out your final bill is $28. So have a look at the examples and the hints and go ahead and solve this coding challenge. All right, so this one shouldn't be too hard. And we're going to start off by creating our first if statement where we're going to check what is the size of the pizza that they chose so we can assign the price to that pizza. If the size is equal to S, that means they ordered a small pizza, well, in this case, the price should be $15, right? Now, we're going to create a variable up here before the if statement so that we can keep track of the bill. So size S, the bill is going to be increased by $15. Now, you can, of course, simply just set the bill to $15 in this case, but because we've got a lot of things that can change the bill, it's easier to simply just add 15 to what it is currently using the plus equal sign that you learned about. Then we're going to check with an elif the size is equal to M. So if they chose a medium pizza instead, then the bill is going to increase by $20 instead. And finally, for all other cases, namely if they got a large size pizza, then we're going to increase the bill by $25. Now, notice how here you could have also used an elif and said elif size is equal to L. Well, in that case, the bill increases by 25. And you don't actually need an else statement. It's not required. If you feel like it's easier to read like this, small, medium, large, and what should happen for each case, then you can just leave it like this. But of course, there is an argument to be made that the user might have typed something wrong, right? They might have typed a lowercase letter, they might have typed a completely different letter. So in future lessons, we're going to show you how you can catch these cases and how you can deal with it. But for now, let's just keep our program simple as possible. If they type the wrong letter instead of S, M, or L, then we're just going to overcharge them. So now that we've established what the basic price for their pizza is, we're going to look through the add-ons. We're going to see if they said they wanted to add pepperoni. So if add pepperoni is equal to Y, well, in that case, we're going to need to check if they have a small pizza or a medium and large pizza because the price is different. So we're going to have a nested if function in here. We're going to say if add pepperoni is equal to Y, and then if the size is equal to S, well, in this case, we're only going to add $2 to the bill. But if the size was any other size, basically medium or large, so we can catch that using just an else statement instead of creating three separate if sizes S, if sizes M, etc. And in this case, we're going to add $3 to the bill. So now we've got this case covered. The final thing is whether if they said they wanted extra cheese or not. So if they did, in fact, want extra cheese, well, in that case, all we have to do is just add $1 to the bill. So these are three separate sets of if statements. This one, and this one. And by the end of all of these if statements, as long as we're at the right indentation level, namely right next to the gutter here, then we can go ahead and calculate their bill. and print it out for them. So we can say print, and I'm going to use an F string to insert the bill in here. Print your final bill is, and then I'm going to add a dollar sign, and then inside the curly braces, I'm going to put in the current value of the bill after all of these calculations. So did you manage to get it right? Did you manage to use a combination of if statements and elif statements, nested if statements, or did you do it in a different way? And it's totally cool if you did. As long as it does what it's supposed to do, then it doesn't really matter whichever format of your code you decided to go for. And as a matter of fact, there's loads of ways that you could have written this code to get this functionality. Some of them will be slightly more readable, some of them will be slightly less readable. So it's a case of you making a good judgment on that and choosing the code that makes the most sense to you. Now, in the next lesson, I want to talk a little bit about combining different conditions so that we can use something called a logical operator to check for multiple conditions in the same line of code. So for all of that and more, I'll see you on the next lesson.